Alrighty guys, welcome back. Today we are doing, it's a Roger Taylor solo song that he wrote, that he did. It's Total Roger. This was recommended to us, what? Oh, I thought you were going to say something.
No.
Oh, okay. And this was recommended to us after Only the Good Dies Young video that we did. Yeah, so Teresa Anderson, this video is for you as well. Yeah, you had your shoulder surgery yesterday.
It's hard to say, isn't it?
Yeah, and so this is a you know, get well soon. Hope you're back to normal. You know, soon.
Quickly.
Yeah, quickly, and you can watch this while you recover. Or this is Roger's tribute to Freddie. And
did you mention the name?
Oh yeah, this is Old Friends.
I
said all of this
and
forgot to mention the name. This is Old Friends, and this is a lyric video because we couldn't find an official Queen studio version or like even a live version. Mm-hmm. So this is like a fan account, Roger Taylor fan account or whatever. But it's a good lyric video of it, and it's really, really it's a pretty song. So we thought we'd do it.
So anyway, so why don't we
just get into
go
it
ahead and get started.
All right, let's get started, guys.
The sun got big and the night came down. We used to share a drink and let the demons out. We let the good times rock, you made the bad times roll. We used to laugh a lot, you had a lot of soul. Old friends in better times. Times were tough. We put our backs to the wall. You used to strut your stuff. With a head held high and a heart so big, a one fist at the sky, the shake a leg. All friends in better times. Times.
period. So what do you think about that?
Wow. That's a cool song.
You like that?
That is a cool song. I like the I like the stinger on the end. Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's why it's a period. It's like it's a defining endpoint.
Could have just been exclamation point too.
Yeah, that's
You know, however you want to take it.
Yeah.
But that is number one. You pick out stuff like that. You know, that's a cool way to.
It's a musician.
It's thing. A musician yeah. thing, right? But it's a cool way to end it and make it definite.
Yeah.
You know, which is cool.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
He was Roger certainly was super complimentary.
Yeah.
Of Fred in there.
Yeah.
The you know, kind of takes me back to those staged Bo Rap scenes where they had their arguments,
right.
You know, and come on, show me what kind of a boxer you are. Really
yeah,
are,
but
stuff like
even
that.
When you're going through
but
all it, that, you
but
realize.
That's what friends do.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
you realize, you know, the memories and everything they've had with each other. And, you know, whether it be good memories or bad memories, you know, whatever
well,
it may
are,
be.
You know, well.
Yeah, it's how close they were to
you. Well, that's
you.
How you know that somebody's a real friend of yours.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, because it's not just always the. It's not just always the. You know, maybe a shallow, hey, you know,
right.
good job
yeah,
or whatever.
I'll see you every tour,
you
know,
you have
weeks.
To.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Really super good friends, you tick each other off. Okay.
Yeah.
Gotta make sure I say the right things on this thing. Okay. You tick each other off. You separate for an hour or two. You come back. It's like nothing ever happened.
Yeah, that's how it is with guys.
That's how it is with guys.
That's how it is with guys. You get mad at each other, and then, you know, may say a few choiced words, go out, grab a beer, come back, and then watch the football game. And then that's about it.
That's pretty much it.
We try to drop it.
That's pretty much it. It's kind of done. It's over. It's buried. And let's move on, right? And, you know, so the good times, the bad times, the...
That's why they call it the good, bad, and the ugly.
Right. Well, yeah, the ugly times.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, you know, and you have your disagreements and all that kind of stuff, but you always come back, and, you know, that is, you know, that's what I got out of there. It reminded me of some stuff that reminded me of a old friend of yours, good friend of yours. You know, everybody has, like, a good friend in high school or college that you always are hanging out with, no matter how...
Your adopted son.
Pardon me?
I said your adopted son.
My adopted son.
My best friend for like 10 years. Oh my goodness. That we've gone off and, I mean, we've literally done, you name it, we've probably done it. We've been in band together since middle school. We went to the same daycare. You know, we were there for each other through everything. We've played pranks on people.
Right.
Yeah.
Hanging out, getting in trouble together.
Yeah.
You know, having those ugly times when you didn't talk to each other for a while, and then all of a sudden...
We come back and we say, well, that was stupid.
Yeah. Exactly.
It's like, no, why are we not talking again? And we're like, I have no freaking idea.
So, you know, and that's exactly, that's why this song,
right.
was, even though it's... you know, even though it's a Freddie Roger thing.
Yeah, okay. It can be, you know, you can associate
it's so
it with
relatable.
Yeah.
With, you know, I mean, I had friends and, you know, have friends from high school and college.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, so my closest friends, they're on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One doesn't do a whole lot, you know, so I don't really know really what's going on with him, but I was at his wedding and everything, you know. But...
that's what reunions are for.
Yeah, well, that's... yeah, that's what reunions are for.
When you can actually go the week in advance.
Or to get reacquainted, yeah, right. But they... You know, but this is also a good reminder, like for me, as I was listening to this and I was thinking about those guys, okay, that as you get older, and, you know, now in Freddie's case, time... slipped, you know, because of health.
Right.
Okay. But as far as me, as I get older, it's just because of age. Right. And you know, and everybody else around me is getting older, mm-hmm. you know, as well. So it's not, it's age, it's health, it's distance.
Time waits for no one.
Time, it's true. That's exactly right. That's exactly right. But the big, you know, but the, I guess the big point is, you know, I'm thinking about these guys now and it's like, man, I really should talk to them now before this turns into a tribute. you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, so.
So I try to get up to one of those last minute reunions.
My high school class has this thing about, you know, nobody knows anything that there's even going to be a reunion going on.
Yeah.
You know, and all of a sudden you get a Facebook thing on a Monday saying, hey, hope to see you guys on Saturday. And it's like,
seriously, I'm working on Saturday.
It's like 400 miles away and, you know, can't get the time off or anything like that.
It's a week in advance.
You know, it's crazy. You know, but you know.
That's what you get for growing up in a little
town. In a small
town.
Definitely in a small town. It's
I was being nice to him.
It's the town where when you stop at the stoplight in the middle of the night, and somebody says, and you hear somebody yell out, and they say, hey, you need to slow down. And you look over, and there's a cop car sitting there, right? And the cop car, or the voice out of there, or the person you're with goes, Larry, is that you? Or Roger, is that you? And it's like, Charlie? Is that?
Yeah, guys,
just watch what you're doing.
Everybody knew everybody.
That's the small town that I was from.
Yeah, everybody knew everybody.
But let's get back, but we need to get back on this thing. Okay. But the whole point is that, you know, listen to this, take advantage of the time that you have,
mm-hmm.
okay, with the friends that you have, you know, and really make those old friend memories versus having to talk about them in the past.
Right.
You know, do it now.
Right.
Okay, that's what I get out of this. Okay, so, but it is a really cool song. It's a really cool tribute, and
I like the bongos.
You know, it was so
I don't know if they're bongos or not, but I like
there was so much percussion, and you could tell it was Roger.
Yeah.
Okay, because there was that going on.
Was it strong enough?
Did you hear that? That was strong enough. Did you
strong enough for the B side?
Did you hear that? That was strong enough for the A side. Did you hear the like the maracas?
Yeah.
Song? Okay.
Yeah.
And I just keep thinking somebody I forget who it was. I think it was, well, I know it was one of the, one of the subscribers. I think I know who it was, but was talking about Roger and his maracas and, you know, throwing a maraca out in the audience or something, you know, but that's what, you know, you were just hearing this and I'm just like, man, that was so easy to get into.
You're grooving with it.
So anyway, It was a cool song. I liked it.
Yeah.
Thanks
to all of you who recommended, but I really think it was, I think it was Teresa who recommended it the first time because she messaged me on Patreon.
Okay.
So thank you so much, Teresa especially, and everybody else. And Teresa, I hope.
A quick recovery.
Yeah, and a quick recovery to you as well. I hope you're back on your feet soon. Don't forget to check out the Teespring link that's down in the description below where we have shirts, hoodies, long sleeve t-shirts, tank tops, breast cancer awareness t-shirts, mugs, phone cases for both iPhone and Android users. Get those while you can. I'm working on some new, you know, logos and some new stuff to, you know, add on there. So, you know, these might be, you know, a little bit older stuff, you know, coming up soon. So make sure you get those while you can. The OG stuff. Along with the Patreon link that's down in the description as well. That's kind of our VIP, you know, next level, you know, gain that you can do for yourself to be a supporter, where you can range from shout outs, description mentions, you know, help us with videos, ideas, Q&A questions, you know, stuff like that. Know exactly when, you know, we're going live, you know, stuff like that. Apart from a whole bunch of other stuff that's down the road, you know, that is to come. But I do owe a few people some Patreon shoutouts. That'd be Paula Johnson, Patricia Miller, Teresa Anderson, and Hotspace. Thank you so much for your countless love and support of the channel. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here. It's really a core group, you know, people that really motivates us and keep us going. So we greatly appreciate it. The little announcement that I've been making, at 1,000 subs, we will open up a P.O. box so we can receive gifts, letters, drawings, whatever it may be. So make sure you subscribe down below. It is free, but make sure you just subscribe down below so we can hit that goal and then open up a P.O. box. And, you know, it's just another way for you and us
to communicate, to bond,
you know, and whatnot. And if we like your letter, drawing, whatever, enough, we may put it out in a video. Ooh. So, anyway, yep. I'm good. Are you good?
Yeah, I'm awesome.
Okay.
Okay,
if you enjoyed this video, make sure you smack that like button, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you all in the next one. Peace out, guys.